Hello everybody, welcome to Vista View Park. My name is Shadow Phoenix. This is my Planet Coaster Park that I have been working on since the actual release of the game. Some of you guys have seen this. I'm sure if you are one of my returning viewers, you have been watching the videos, hopefully religiously, every time I release one. For those of you who are new to the park, I thought this would be a great time to do a walkthrough of some of the changes and stuff that has happened during the building process, because, you know, we just got finished with Thunder Run, which is a huge coaster in the park, and I thought it would be a great idea just kind of go back over and look over everything, because I've made some other changes too that just didn't deserve an actual build time lapse and everything, so that's what we're doing. So first of all, we have our actual entrance, which was not designed by me. This is the modern European entrance from the Steam Workshop. It's an awesome entrance. I haven't really changed too much on it, just a few things here and there, just very, very small details I took off and added a few other things. You will notice the little trees I added to the actual entrance sign, and those are going to stay. However, unfortunately, as much as I love this entrance, it does have to go. And the reason for that is that there's a train coming. Yep, it's going to be coming right down through there, and this is going to be a station, as well as the entrance for the park, and go over that way as well, and back into the park. So it's gonna go all the way around the park. Because of that, the entrance has to go. We have to totally redesign everything on the entrance, and I'm not sure how I'm gonna do that just yet. I'm gonna try to keep it as close as possible, but we'll just have to see what happens. So, yeah. Hopefully we can keep some of it, though. I really, really, really like this entrance, and I hate to see it go, but you guys, you take a good look. This could be the last time you see this entrance in its current form. At least if you watch the videos, anyway. Alright, so let's kind of go down through here, and let's go on into the park. Pardon me, coming through, I have I'm a VIP. I have a very important pass. Alright, we have our sign, or not sign, we have our floral clock. Why didn't I say sign? Our flower clock, right there at the beginning. This is one of the awesome things that I built in the very beginning of the park. And I guess I don't really give it too much of, you know, a view. I take that back. I give it a whole lot of view. I love this thing. I really, really love it. One thing I've noticed is since the 1.2 update, if you guys have any of these little bushes that were once white and are now recolorable, it has now put them all to like this light green color, which isn't right. So I got to go back through here and fix this. I literally just noticed this today. So if you guys haven't noticed that, you may want to go back into your park and fix that. So, this is Main Street. Not a whole lot has changed on Main Street, I don't think, since the last time you saw. We'll take a look through that in a little bit. We have Time Spiral over there, and our Ferris wheel, some other things. That's if we go over to the right. But we're not going to the right today. No, sir. We are going to the left. Over into this new area. This is where Thunder Run is, over in this area here. Something I built today was this rock wall. And this literally took me half the day to put this wall up down through there. It took me a good hour to figure out what kind of wall I wanted to do. While on my Twitch stream, I actually let some of my viewers kind of help me pick out which one we went with. One thing I do hate about this wall is you can tell it's just placement after placement after placement. It's got a run-on fence. There's no really uniqueness to it, and that causes it to look off. Very, very weird and off. So we're gonna have to try to figure out a way to randomize these rocks a little bit up through there so it doesn't look the same all the way up through there. And let's move on up into here. And oh, you can see Alpenkurse from here. This is our Entangled ride. It is the witch's ride that is the family kind of thing here. Most of the coaster or the rides right here in this section are kind of family rides. I did do this today as well. I finished all this up, which is the queue line and a few other things. Let's take a look at the entrance. This looks better every time I see it. It really does. Let me get that off there. Sorry about that, guys. I did not mean for that to be on there. I am recording this live. I'm talking to you as I'm actually going through the park with you. So this is all actual, like, live and recorded. So. This is the sign for Entangled, and I kind of built a little, let's go over here, you can kind of see it. It's got a little entrance, kind of a dark area into it. So it is kind of got a dark theme to it. I also finished up this kind of, well, not really finished up. I did a lot of work here in this plaza area. There's the teacups. We'll take a walk around the teacups here. I don't know if I showed this off in my last video or not, but we have all of this little area. I think I did, but I did all of this work on these buildings back here, and you can't really see them for the teacups, right? Because the teacups are just like huge with this pavilion over top of it. Luckily, we can now lower that thanks to 1.2, and it's no collision detection. Over in there, you have that goes over to Main Street, so it's kind of a shortcut for those who know it. These guys know what I'm talking about, right? Right? Yeah, you do. All right. That's our Dodgems is inside of that building there. You can access the bumper cars from the Main Street, and that's the building that houses them right there. And again, back over here in our plaza area, my janitors are not doing their job. We're getting a lot of dirt and trash and stuff on our really, really nicely paved park. I pay these guys a lot. You'd think they'd do their job. All right, anyway. This right here, this fence, I couldn't make it fit just right, so luckily there's a small little piece that kind of fits in a small area, and I kind of lowered it slightly in the ground to make it look like a gate, because once we actually put some more flowers and stuff in here, then this will be where the gardeners will enter, is in through those little gates here and there. Alright, that goes, you can see Alpenkurs coming off of its lift hill into an Immelmann and down. This is where our rock wall ends, right here. I have it where it kind of goes into the ground right there, and then the train will be coming around this bend here, so you'll be able to get a good view of the train when it comes through there. Also, you'll be able to see it from here as well. Pretty much from anywhere in the path, really, you'll be able to see it up and down through here. It's saving. That's why I just did that. This is something I built today as well. I did a lot of work today, just on like small stuff. Yo! Awesome, we got actually people sitting here. Check this out. Now, some of you guys have seen this in other videos. It is kind of a very well-known trick right now, but you take the benches and you put them under stuff, and people will sit on the whatever it is you put on top of the benches. In this case, we have a nice little kind of resting area, kind of where you can sit and eat from buying the food that's over there. I threw an information booth in this section. I'm too low. I swear I'm not trying to look up your skirt at this moment. Anyway, so yeah, we did the information booth here, and then we did a Gopi there. So originally there was just a Gopi in this building, and that was it. And I put the information booth in there instead because there's a clock there, and I thought that would be a nice kind of way. Plus, you can get your priority passes there to get on Alpenkurs if you need to. Because I mean, look how busy this thing is. Alpenkurs is really, really busy. It really is. And it's got a priority pass line. So I think it's been broken down, and that's why everybody's kind of heading over to it right now. You see people are coming out of it and then going back in because it was broken down and now it's not. There's some sections of the path that I couldn't fix right here, so I covered that up. Let's keep going. I haven't done the station yet for Alpenkurs or anything really on Alpenkurs other than just the layout. So we'll have to get back into that later on. There's a security camera right there. Smile for the security camera, guys. Say cheese. All right. No more pickpocketers. I actually have the pickpocketing thing turned off and security turned off in this part because I kept, in this one little area right here, I kept getting more pickpocketing things going on here than anywhere else in the park. And I could not catch them. I've got like 3 security guards. I got a camera here. There's a camera over there. And I could not catch the pickpocketer. So I was just like, you know what? Screw it. Turn it off. It's one more thing I don't need to worry about trying to build my park. So the generic bathroom that I found in a workshop that I absolutely positively love. You will see this. This is the second time I placed it in the park. It's got a third one. And I'm sure that there will be more as well. Actually, there's 4. Yeah. This is our Rocktopus, or Monster as it's referred to in some parks, and this one doesn't have a name. It's got an entrance over there with no name. On the workshop, if you guys love this, you can get this on the workshop. All of this is actually included, and you can grab it there. My workshop link will be down below, and you just click on that and download this or anything else that you see that you'd like in my workshop. Make sure you give me an upvote there as well, because I'd love to make it to the front page. So just a shout out for myself there. Would very much appreciate that. But this is also the 1.2 update, collision detection, made things like this possible. And we were able to place the Roctopus, which I love the Roctopus, but a giant octopus in an alpine park didn't fit. This is better. So yeah. You get a great view all the way down through here. All the way around, you get an awesome view of Alpenkurs. It's got some great shots if you're a camel-friendly person. Shout out to Rudy Rankin, I guess. Then you will get some great shots there. But yeah, there's our entrance. Again, needs a name. If you guys got an idea for a name for this, then you can place it down in the comments below, and I will consider it. If it's a good name, it will go up there. If not, I'll have to keep thinking of a name. I was on the workshop. This is listed under Entangled Twister, but we call it our Witch's Ride Entangled, so this one doesn't really have a name at the moment. So yeah. Oh, somebody's got a pirate hat. Wait, how does he have a pirate hat? I shouldn't be selling pirate hats anywhere. A janitor's not hard at work there. Alright, this is our kind of a plaza where you can grab just about all the food you want. I think we got... What do we have in here? Let's just take a look. We got a chief beef, we got a gopi, manjil fries, and some more gopi energy drinks, I think. The top part, that will be a train station, accessible from here, because the train will come down through this way. Now there's our timber tower. Again, another great shot of Alpenkurs. It comes around as helixes there. Let's take a look up here. This is a cool area up in here. A little patio to eat on, and you get some great shots of all the final spins that you get on Thunder Run right here. At night, this has some lights shining on it right there, so you can see it. Something else I added. We'll cut through here. Coming through. VIP. There's our queue line for Timber Tower. Timber Tower you can also grab on the workshop as well, if you guys like this. You'll get a better look at it here in just a minute. But its queue line winds all the way around the back of it in kind of a half circle. We built a little ice cream shop here because people love ice cream. What have you got there? That looks really good. Now I want some ice cream. Benches, all kinds of things. No, I swear I wasn't calling you that. I was talking about the actual benches. Okay, here we go. Let's take a look at Timber Tower. I took logs. This is actually one of the first things I did with the 1.2 update, is this right here. I threw down a bunch of logs around this and some rocks and made this really, really kind of, you know, a really nice ride for this park. Hopefully you guys will like it. It will fit in a Western themed park as well. Any kind of rustic park, this would be perfect in. And you can grab this on the workshop as well. This is the entrance to Thunder Run. I do not know why there's a rock right there. This rock was not here a minute ago. Okay. So we'll ghost through this over here to get... While you're in queue for Thunder Run, you get a great, great view of its final turns. Comes off of that, over this little U-turn here, banked U-turn, up into that, down, back in into the station, which is over in there. The queue line will wind down around there, up around this. That tree has some lights on it. Yeah. Let's take a look at this sign. You guys saw this sign and the video for Thunder Run, but I'm sure this is a much closer look at it. You can kind of see how I did it. I just put some rocks up there, and it's all made out of just the pieces, the art pieces. That's how I did that. And there's a Gopi sign right there, the Gopi Lightning Boat. He's going to inspect Thunder Run. That's nice. It needs inspecting. Here's a cart. Obviously, this cart has been here a while. Just a little detail that I added. Again, not too many people will notice that, especially from the videos and stuff that I do of the actual things. Here's the entrance through Timber Tower. Timber Tower makes a lot of people sick. So, and my janitors don't like cleaning up vomit, obviously. As much as I pay them, they don't want to do it. It winds around this way, back into here, and it goes around. Well, let's come over here. You can kind of see it. As well as Alpencurse, you can kind of see how the queue line winds around there. Let's go back out here. Doo-doo-doo. There's our generic bathroom again. Painted a different color, but still. This tree right here in the middle of this, I love this view. We did a little patio area over here, and when I was doing a pass and stuff, I ended up with this little kind of triangular spot there that I couldn't do anything with. And I threw this tree down here, and the way the branches are and everything on this just is absolutely beautiful. This is one of my favorite spots in the park right here. I love this just this one spot. And it's also got a great little patio over here you can eat on, and a great view of Alpencurse. Again, coming off of one of its emblems down into there. We got a Gopi and a pizza place here. There's Thunder Run, there's its Rosebow. You guys can see this. This is a great view right here. Let me unpause the game. We got our creek. Ravine that kind of comes out through there. Oh, there it goes. Yeah, it's a really, really fast ride. That goes down into a little like creek area, down through a ravine, and Thunder Run, as you know, if you've watched the video, if you haven't, I highly suggest go watch it, but it runs down through there into this ravine and up into there before it even gets to the lift hill. So that is an awesome spot right there. Now that goes up to where our Avalanche ride is. You can see Alpencurse's lift hill from here, and it's in the one right there. We won't go up into that area because there's really nothing up there to see yet, so we're gonna bypass that. Instead, we're gonna go down in here. This is the newest area of the park. This is where our log flume and stuff is, and the game saved again. Let's take a look at this bridge. People love this bridge. This is something that a lot of people have really, really liked that I've done here lately. The bridge you can also get on the workshop. Again, my Steam Workshop link is down below in the description of the video. This is all made out of, like the two towers holding up the bridge are made out of very, very small rocks. And I did that so I could get the arches and stuff just right. This was not easy to do. This whole bridge took me a couple of hours altogether. The rock work itself was at least an hour work, if not longer. Excuse me. Coming through. Kind of get a good look here. This also goes up and around, so you can kind of come down or you can kind of come up from down there. It's just kind of an alternate path for going up that way. We have our timber mill log flume coming off of its final run right there into the final splashdown. That is not the final product. This will look 10 times better when I'm done with it, but we haven't really done a whole lot of work with the log flume yet. That will be the next big ride you guys will see with the POV and cinematic views. Slow ride, kind of meanders around, but it's got some great views, and that's the beautiful thing about that. Thunder Run does go over top of Thunder Run, and we'll take a look at that in just a minute. Down through this wooded area, and there again you can see the log flume going back down into there. Here's some fences, custom fences I did. Again, these same fences are up around Alpencurse as well. These aren't actually on the workshop. I'm thinking about putting them up there, though, just to see how many people would be willing and interested in getting those. There's our generic bathroom again. Apparently, I missed a spot in the coloring process, but there is our log flume going into making its final run into the station. And you can kind of see, I love the colors of this. It's beautiful, beautiful colors of the log flume. It really is. We'll unpause it. You'll notice it's got a leak right there, right as it goes over top of the Thunder Run coaster. Beautiful. That's the one thing about this park, is I strive to get not to beauty, basically, is what I'm working on. The whole idea of this park is just to get the most beautiful views of the park that I can. That is what I'm striving for. It's not about excitement. It's not about getting the largest thrill rides or anything like that. It's just, I love having beautiful views of everything. This is our timber mill. This is the station. I'm going to unpause it again so you guys can see. We have a working sawmill kind of built onto that. There's a flume coming in. Unpause it back again. This is its first drop right here. Kind of our first splash down right here next to the station. Makes for a great view. Kind of excites you right before you get on the ride. And let me just tell you something about Timbermill Log Flume. You will get wet on this ride. Guaranteed. I'm going to make sure you do, because I'm going to have a lot of different places in there where you will be getting wet on this ride. Let's take a look down in here. This is our station. One thing I got, and I'm going to make a shout out here again to Bro Coaster Series, Mass Bandit in 7. Specifically Ryan, where he guested on their series and did their log flume. A lot of this, I took a cue, no pun intended, of their actual cue line, and kind of I made it my own, but a lot of this is very basically modeled after a lot of the stuff they did. We have a water tower here in the middle. It does go over, but you know, again, this is something that a lot of log flumes, maybe not a lot, but some log flumes also have something like this as well, where you do a walkover right above the actual where it exits or enters into the station. And then we have our queue line, which goes back in there and back around. You guys will eventually see more of that in the final video for the log flume. That's really all I have to show off of that right now. This over here, we have a little covered kind of walkway underneath of this. And this will go over into this area. I did a poll on my Twitter feed. You guys could choose what the big coaster was going to be over in this area here, because we opened up this area and had room for a coaster. I really, really wanted to do a boomerang. You guys had other plans. You chose the mine coaster. So we'll have a mine coaster over in that area in there. Trapper Smokehouse, which will be modeled a little bit after the one at Busch Gardens, will be right here. And there's our train station. That's the first train station in the park, and some of the tracks and stuff that it comes down through here. That will be it in this area. Just a little tiny detail here that I want to... When I was building this, the path, I didn't flatten the terrain out very well. And I did the path over it. And when I started doing all the rest of the paths and stuff and coming off of it, if I delete this one section to flatten this out, it messes with every single path right here. It takes out a huge chunk, and I just couldn't do it. So instead, I come up with a reason why that is like that. And we have a little branch here coming off of this tree. So this tree has been here so long that we built the paths and stuff around it. And now, as you can see, it's actually lifting up the stone here in the actual thing. Something else I kind of took from Mass Bandit and the Bro Coaster series, they did that as well. N7 did that, and I thought it was a really cool idea, and it worked for me as well there. So just a little bit of realism. So we're going to head back across the bridge here. We're going to head back to the entrance of the park. We're going to take a right. You guys have already seen Time Spiral on that. Nothing has really changed in that area, but some of you guys may be just tuning into my series. Now, if you don't watch me on Twitch, you don't know what the actual rest of the park looks like. So this is kind of a great way, basically, to get a good view of it and kind of a walkthrough. Because I get a lot of people who's like, hey, can I see your park? You know, when I'm streaming and stuff on Twitch. And this is a great walkthrough of it where you can actually get a good view from the peeps' point of view and everything. So we're going to head back over to the beginning of the park, and we're going to take a right instead of a left. I will see you guys in just a minute. Okay, here we are back at the beginning of the park. So as I said, we're going to take a right. We took a left before. Now we're going to take a right. We're going to wind around and come back on Main Street and before we end the video. Again, just beautiful, beautiful views in this. Planet Coaster did a great job on the backgrounds and stuff too. I love the way the mountains and stuff are on this actual map. This is Time Spiral. One of my best creations I think I've ever done. I've put 36 hours of work into this coaster. You can definitely tell when you watch the video. If you guys haven't watched it yet, definitely go do that. This will be, it's on my YouTube channel. Just go back into the series here and you will find it. It's it's Dr. Cogsworth's Clockworks, basically, is the idea of it. And he is testing his new perpetual motion machine. And I call it Time Spiral. there you go. That is that. I'm not going to talk a whole lot about this. There's not a whole lot really to show off in this area, like I said, because you guys, if you guys have been tuning in every week, you guys have seen this. There's no reason to talk about it a whole lot. You can go back and watch the video if you need to of this. It's got some great shots. This is Lady Designers, or Delay Designers, Fairy Tale Shops that have been altered a little bit with Ryan's Pavilion. And I put a hyperspin under that pavilion and combined all three of these together to make a beautiful, beautiful area right there. Unfortunately, nobody wants to ride the hyperspin, so it doesn't really matter. The peeps are dumb. They don't notice the beauty and everything, but we do. We notice the beauty, right? All right. This is our giant Ferris wheel. I love the look of that thing. And it's riding on right on top of our Fest House, October Fest House, which will be another plaza eating area, and then you will have the entrance to a whole other area there over there, which we haven't even built yet. A little steampunkish water pump station that I got off the workshop, which fits perfectly into the rest of this. Beautiful water. You know what I need? I need a place in this park where you can get a beautiful piece of chocolate cake. Yes. All right, let's see. We have some shops, which are two different shops. I took this one and this one are the same shop. I just angled them and then combined them with this one to make a whole new building. And all three of these were on the workshop. I just combined them together to make a really cool building right there. We got a Chief Beef restaurant right there. Very alpine-ish as well. We've got a little secret area. You can kind of go up in here. This is not finished up here, but it will be a plaza going over into our Ferris wheel, which apparently has just been either fixed or inspected. Don't know. There's Avalanche and the station, and you have a bridge that will go across over there to get to that, but not showing that off today because there's nothing up there to see. I mean that literally. There's literally nothing up there to see, so don't worry about it. Then we're back on Main Street. And I'm fairly certain... Nope, we got a closed shop right there. Fairly certain you guys have seen all of this before. I don't need to go into a whole lot of detail, so we're just going to walk around. All of these buildings on this side of the street were all done by me, except for these corner buildings right here. But this right here, those are bumper cars. You can see... Fairly certain I showed all this off in the last video, so I still haven't put any shops in these buildings yet. I will get around to that. This is where you can go over to the teacups at. It's a little secret path. I did add this on there. I think you guys didn't see this last time. This is a Fox Coffee in there, but I added these little doors in there. Again, just for a little bit of realism. And that will be it. So, I hope you guys have enjoyed this walkthrough of Vista View. Again, my name is Shadow Phoenix. You can catch me on my Twitch channel, Building. I'm usually on Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. And I may not always be playing Planet Coaster, but if you want to watch my streams on Twitch, you can find me there below. The link is down below in the channel. If you're not already one of my subscribers here on YouTube, definitely click that button to subscribe so you can catch out the rest of the videos and stuff, the time lapses, everything else that I do here, as well as other videos I do. Roller Coaster Tycoon 3, gonna try to get in some Ark and some City Skylines here soon. And yeah, so that is Vista View Park, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in the next video. So wherever you are in the world, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, or good night.